Ron Galella for Penolta.
I'm a nobody, a paparazzo, but I'm chasing the most desirable woman in the world, Jackie O. If you're like me, you want every picture to turn on half decent. That's why I use a Penolta MX. It's a super camera. Penolta MX is totally waterproof. And you don't have to screw around with f-stops or light meters. Everything's automatic.
You? I thought you were in jail.
And another super feature is a built-in motor drive. But when you gotta take a lot of pictures in a hurry. And the Penolta MX comes equipped with an 8-second delay switch, which lets yous get in the picture. Would Madame like some ketchup on her escargot? Say cheese, Jackie! And it also pays the rent.
The Penolta MX. It's super.
Tired of ordinary television? Don't touch that dial. SCTV is now on the air. Starring John Candy, Joe Flaherty.
We interrupt this program to bring you an SCTV news update. The SCTV janitorial staff has voted to strike because of a breakdown in contract negotiations. The vote was 1-0 with 4 abstentions. Staff and crew at SCTV announced they would support the striking janitors and observe all picket lines. A public statement will be forthcoming.
Eugene Levy. Andrea Martin. Television like you've never seen it before. This is the SCTV Television Network.
The following announcement paid for by the Contingency Fund for Janitorial Services Local 13.
Hello. So, strike. When you're getting stiff, you strike. So that's what we did. And I'll tell you why. Because here at SCTV, they give you so that you get 15 minutes for lunch. So 15 minutes. You can't have a bowl of soup in that time. And if it's hot, there's 10 minutes waiting for it to cool. So what else? So what about pension? They said you get a pension. The next thing you want is a 6-day week. I said, yes. A 6-day week and no working on Hanukkah. So what else? And we don't do windows. You can get the window people to do that because it's very dangerous to go up to clean them. So we don't do. Yes, I'm taking a very tough stand because that's the kind of guy I am. I'm tough as nails. Tough.
Very senile old geezer.
Entire station's going out on sympathy strike, huh?
Yeah. They think I'm gonna buckle under just because some janitors don't have time for hot soup.
Yes, Mr. Cavalier.
Shirley, get me Edith Prickly.
Mrs. Prickly's on vacation with Pietro Dole.
All right, thanks, Shirley. Great. She picks a fine time to be on vacation with the Prime Minister of Canada.
What am I going to do? Programming. Reruns. I can't do any more reruns. Viewers will be down on my neck like a hickey. Not to mention our fine, fine press people. This is bad. Like that football strike. Football strike. Pierre Trudeau! Yes! Yes!
Yes, Mr. Cavalier.
Shirley, I want you to get me Edith Brickley, no matter what it takes.
Yes, sir.
Well, Pierre Trudeau, that man's inexplicable taste in women might just be the answer to my problem.
Give me anything I want. And a couple of things I don't want. Zithers. And you want me to negotiate. Well, tell him to meet me in my office. I'll catch the red eye and I'll be there first thing in the morning. A biento. I'd stay out of the sun if I were you. Excuse me, dear. Your trainer called. You're due for the fourth race at Belmont. Well, looking pretty good, dear. Pierre, if I ever asked you for a favor?
I wish you would, my darling. I'd give you anything.
Well, why don't we go to the mud club and I'll explain it all to you.
All right.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, the president of the SCTV network, Mr. Guy Caballero.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. What time is it, anyway?
3:30.
Thank you, Lola. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Now, no doubt by now you're all aware of the strike, which has literally crippled the creative process here at SCTV. As a member of the management team, I'm sure I don't have to tell you how much I disdain strikes. They ruin what seems to be a perfectly good day, and, well, they always end up costing us money. And worst of all, it seems you, the public, always are the ones to suffer. Well, not here at SCTV. This strike will not put a crimp into our programming. There will be no reruns. Instead, we look to our friendly neighbors to the north. The Canadians, the Canucks, those affable snow creatures who live on the other side of the world's longest unguarded border. Thanks to the Canadian government, or le gouvernement du Canada, we will be picking up the feed to another fine network, the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation, allowing you to share their entertaining programming right here on SCTV. So why don't you just sit back, relax, and don't worry about this silly strike business. With the help of the CBC, I think we can wait this thing out.
This is the Canadian Broadcasting Corporation.
The woodchuck is found in open woods and ravines throughout most of Canada and the Northeast United States. A terrestrial day-active animal, the woodchuck hibernates in snowy climes. For more information, contact Parks and Recreations Canada, Ottawa.
This season, the CBC, recognized the world over as the leader in sports coverage, brings you for the 10th consecutive year.
Rotate.
Monday Night Curling with your announcers, Dandy Dick Bedloe, Gord McKee, and Gord McClellan. You'll be there for all the exciting play-by-play action and color commentary, as well as the weekly curling tip with Howie McMeeker. Winner of 25 Nellie Awards for its outstanding coverage, Monday Night Curling is back as only the CBC can cover it.
Sweep, 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 sweep.
In fact, this is Bramley's final throw, and if Skip Hugh McKechnie can knock out that shot rock, Bramley will take the game.
There's this shot.
And it looks like a good one.
Monday Night Curling. Monday nights at 8, 7:30 in Newfoundland. You're watching CBC on SCTV. The Canadian Fact Ministry presents It's a Canadian Fact.
Did you know that though many Americans are married in their homeland, they will not consummate it anywhere but in Niagara Falls, Canada, which are twice as big as those on the American side? Did you? It's a fact.
It's a Canadian Fact. Brought to you by CanFax, your Canadian Fact Ministry. It's Canada's longest-running panel game show, Headline Challenge. And here's the amiable host of Headline Challenge, Dougal Curry.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Before I introduce the panel, I would like to announce that tonight's episode of Headline Challenge marks the 35th season on primetime national television. Let's see, any other notes? No. So let's introduce the panel. First, the devilishly handsome Philip Marx.
Thank you, Dougal. I will take that as a compliment. Well,
good, good. I understand, Philip, you just returned from one of my favorite cities, Moncton.
That's correct, Dougal. I participated in the festivities at the Miss Moncton pageant.
Well, aren't you the lucky one? Perhaps next time you'll take me with you.
Only if you behave yourself.
I will. And now the delightful young lady to your left, our guest panelist this evening, the First Lady of Canadian Theatre, Sandra Wicks.
Thank you, Dougal.
It's a pleasure to have you with us tonight, Miss Wicks. You honor us with your presence.
The challenge tonight, Dougal, seems to be mine. For you see, tonight I have no masks to put on, eh? I have no characters to hide behind. Tonight, you see, I am appearing as myself, Sandra Wicks. And perhaps it is the most challenging role I have ever had to play, with the possible exception of Johnny Belinda, which I'm sure some of your audience will remember me playing. I didn't play Johnny. I played the mother. And I walked in and I said, is everything all right, Johnny?
Very good, Sandra. And to your left, the quintessential Canadian celebrity, author and regular panelist, Austin McGrath.
I compliment you on the use of the word quintessential, Dougal.
Ooh.
It's a word I've used in my writings many, many times.
I think perhaps, Austin, you're the one man who has written more books than I've read.
I don't know what you mean.
Well, it's just that you've written so many books.
And you haven't read them?
No. I've read your books, Austin. I just haven't read that many books.
Well, that being the case, Dougal, I've probably written more books than you've read.
All right, panel. It's time to get serious. Our first guest tonight is linked with a recent headline. Your challenge this evening is to identify that headline. And let's now show that headline to our audience at home.
RCMP investigates personnel misconduct.
Very good. And let's start the questioning with Philip Marks.
Do you have anything to do with the RCMP probe into alleged misconduct within their own organization?
That's it. Panel, our guest tonight is Staff Sergeant Donald McAndrew. And, Sergeant, you didn't do a very good job on stumping our panel this evening.
No, sir, I guess not. Sir?
Well, thank you for being with us tonight on Headline Challenge.
Yes, sir.
Very, very good, Philip. Were you playing a hunch on that one?
Well, here's what happened. The RCMP probe has been a major headline for the past 3 or 4 months, so I put 2 and 2 together, and I'll be darned if it didn't come up 4.
Well, very, very excellent work on that, Philip. And we'll be right back with our mystery guest right after these commercial interruptions.
The Canadian Fact Ministry presents It's a Canadian Fact.
Did you know that Canadians celebrate Thanksgiving at the beginning of October, and yet Americans celebrate their Thanksgiving at the end of November? That means we must have invented it, because we celebrate it first. Did you? It's a fact.
It's a Canadian Fact. Brought to you by CanFacts, your Canadian Fact Ministry.
The woodchuck is found in open woods and ravines throughout most of Canada and the Northeast United States. A terrestrial day-active animal, the woodchuck hibernates in snowy climes. For more information, contact Parks and Recreations Canada, Ottawa.
Welcome back. Our panelists have their blindfolds in place, and we encourage our home audience to play along on this one. Our mystery guest is a popular Canadian actor, and we'll start the questioning with Austin McGrath.
A popular Canadian actor. Pass.
Philip Marks.
You say you're a Canadian actor?
Yes.
I'm going to have to pass.
Sandra Wicks.
I recognize that voice. Is it Raymond Massey?
No.
Panel, I'm afraid we can't spend any more time on this. Would you remove your blindfolds, please? And we'll continue the questioning with Austin McGrath.
That voice is so familiar. I have no idea.
Philip Marks.
And you say you're a popular Canadian actor?
Yes, I am.
Well, I'm afraid we've stumped you on this one, panel. Mystery guest, would you let the panel know exactly who you are?
A terrestrial day-active animal, the woodchuck hibernates in snowy climes.
Oh. Morley Mark. Morley Mark of the hinterland who's
very
who.
Good films. Very good. Morley Markle, veteran Canadian actor. And Morley, good to have you with us. We don't have much time, but I understand you've been doing some radio work recently.
Yes, we're preparing a drama of Macbeth for Stratton.
This is the CBC.
All right, Sid. We're talking strike here. We're talking give and take. We're talking you give and I take. What are your demands?
Well, first of all, and keep in mind, you're looking at the brick wall.
Yeah.
We want 50% of all commercial revenue, and I'm sorry, but I won't budge on that point.
Yeah. But don't mind me, Sid. I haven't had lunch yet. Let's see what we got here. That is one fresh bagel, Sid. Yep, from the Stage Deli in New York City. Now, where were we, Sid? 50%, huh? Nope. You're out of your bird. Minimum pay, that's the best we can do.
Well, I'm sure. Well, 50% and not a decimal less. You got any cream cheese with that?
Give and take.
Well, maybe we can dicker a little bit. So money's not everything. I'll give you that one.
Good boy, Sid. Compromise. It's the name of the game. Okay. What's next?
Seltzer. You got any seltzer?
The strike continues on the next episode of SCTV.